There's an oft-repeated piece of advice among AV enthusiasts. If an HDMI cable is built to spec and it functions properly, there's no reason to spend extra money on something fancy, because a digital transmission isn't nearly as susceptible to interference as an old-school analog connection. In other words, it basically works or it doesn't. And indeed, we did a video on our channel a while back that showed how silly certain over-engineered HDMI cables can be. But that doesn't mean it's always a great idea to buy the cheapest, most bare-bones cable either. So to find out what actually matters when buying an HDMI cable, we spoke to Ugreen, a manufacturer of HDMI cables, and we'd like to thank them as well as Philips AOC and David Sheff for his translation services. So it turns out that using the correct material inside of an HDMI cable can make a big difference, but that doesn't mean that you should go out and find cables with platinum, unobtainium alloy, or whatever other nonsense. Cheaply made HDMI cables sometimes use steel, which isn't a particularly good conductor, meaning it's something that you should generally avoid. You might see cables that are made of copper-coated steel, but these aren't really any better. Instead, go for cables with pure copper wiring inside. The good news, however, is that copper cables aren't super expensive, and you don't need to get anything higher grade such as silver-plated copper. What then becomes important is how thick the wiring is inside, which is measured by something called a gauge number, and counterintuitively, a lower number means a thicker wire. As a general rule of thumb, your cable length shouldn't exceed 1.5 meters with a thin 32-gauge wire. But as you go thicker and thicker, you can safely have a longer and longer cable run without having to worry about signal attenuation or interference because your cables are too thin, as indicated by this helpful chart. However, you won't find much thicker than 24 gauge since at that point, the cables simply become too thick and difficult to bend. Another thing to consider is the connectors on the end of the cable. Gold plating is better if you can find it, but take note that I'm not talking about the large part on the outside that manufacturers often color gold to give the cable a more premium look. I'm talking about the actual contacts on the inside of the connector. Gold plating won't really affect your performance, but it will give you better longevity, as the gold is an effective barrier against wear and corrosion, especially if you're unplugging and replugging the cable quite often, which I don't do because my TV is too close to the wall. Once you've found a cable made with good materials, try and find out if it's been tested to work with a wide variety of equipment. Some cheaper cables are only tested with a couple of monitors, so they might not play very nicely with your gadgets if you're running them in any kind of setup that isn't super straightforward, such as with an HDMI splitter. If the manufacturer doesn't list testing methods on their website, read reviews and find out if any other customers have had problems with compatibility. And on the subject of compatibility, make sure you're buying a premium high-speed cable if you want 4K at 60 Hz or HDR. These have a speed of around 18 gigabits per second as opposed to the 10 gigabits of the more standard high-speed cable, not premium high-speed. And you'll need the extra bandwidth to enable higher frame rates and deeper colors. Interestingly, manufacturers actually made these faster cables not with exotic materials or radical design changes, but simply by improving the manufacturing process to minimize small defects in the copper that can hurt the signal, increase latency, and introduce interference. However, faster speeds still mean a smaller margin for error. So if you're trying to use ultra-high speed 48 gigabit cables to get the most out of HDMI 2.1, for example, you probably don't want to get a cable longer than 3 meters. Just remember, generally speaking, shorter and thicker is better. Just ask Kim K. Or Colton. This video is brought to you by Brilliant. If you're a student, a professional, or just someone who wants to understand the world better, check out Brilliant, the website that helps you reach your learning goals by working just a little bit every day. Brilliant offers interactive explorations and a mobile app to help you master concepts in math, science, and computer science. The courses take complex concepts and break them up into bite-sized chunks. Over time, you'll be amazed at what you can accomplish. We suggest checking out their Mathematical Fundamentals course, which has been redesigned with interactive features to help you with the foundational concepts behind algebra, number theory, and logic, which make it a great resource for STEM students. The first 200 people to head to brilliant.org/techwiki will get 20% off an annual premium subscription. So thanks for watching, guys. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, hit subscribe, and be sure to hit us up in the comments section with your bright ideas of topics that we should cover in the future.